Hey, hello, hello again, everyone. This is Jan from New York City, and my channel name is Jan from New York City Saves Money. Hey, how's everybody doing on this bright and beautiful Wednesday morning? Can you believe it's already Wednesday? Wow, wow, wow. We're really inching up towards the weekend, and then before you know it, it's Thanksgiving Day next Thursday. Yeah, 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 yeah. How's everybody doing in terms of Thanksgiving? Are you ready for the big day? Are you taking it easy? Are you going to do a simple slow cooker meal like the one that we recommended for those who wanted to like take a more laid back approach and save money, or whatever way you're doing it? Of course, I absolutely wish everybody well. If you're just going to kick back and watch a little TV that day, whatever you do, enjoy. You know, even though Thanksgiving is like right around the corner, what else is around the corner, of course, is the Christmas holiday, the gift-giving season of all gift-giving seasons. Although, I personally believe that gifts should be a thing of an all-year-round type thing, and they are, for the most part, with birthdays, anniversaries, graduations, and other occasions. But there are also gifts from the heart that can be given at any time of the year. Now, I'm getting back now to more specifically, we're going to like hone it down a little bit, dial it back to specifically for the Christmas giving season. Now, not everyone has mega bucks to spend on gifts, but the heart wants to do it. And I figured out a few years back a really cool place that's oftentimes overlooked in terms of having a plethora of gift-giving ideas is right under our nose, and it's at our local grocery store. So here's what I really highly recommend, and I could tell you factually that it has worked out very nicely for me. Now, suppose you're on a shoestring budget, you're maybe a single parent, or going through an extra tough time this year. And by the way, because of this year being this year, many people, excuse me, please, are out of work. And, you know, they don't want to admit maybe they're a little bit of food deficient in certain aspects. And this is the perfect gift for someone that, you know, they may have a bunch of kids, or just to get someone a special edible treat. Make up your own gift baskets. Now, I'll tell you a story about me a few years back. This is, of course, well before this crazy year. I just happened to decide to go out and buy a whole bunch of items that were baking items. And I made like a theme of it. Like I got a whole bunch of cake mixes. They were on sale at a good price. I got a whole bunch of teas and coffees that were on sale, cookies. I put all of these things together, hot chocolate, all these things like, you know, like a cozy snack type thing for the holidays and other goodies in there, edibles and things that are keepable. And I made up these little, and not little actually, they turned out to be pretty sizable baskets for my friends and family. And I've been giving gifts my whole life. Can I tell you something? This batch of gifts was one of the most successfully well-enjoyed gifts, in so much as like brownie mixes, and people love that. The wooden spoons, you could get a mixing bowl. So here's my suggestion. Go to your local, you could go to your dollar store. Now, if you know a family that's kind of down on their luck, you know, regarding food and stuff like that, then it would be common sense to think that if you made up a beautiful basket, and it doesn't have to be, by the way, an actual basket. I even made up one of those gift, quote, baskets out of a brand new pail. There was a pail, a big red pail that I stuffed with everything in the kitchen sink. You could get those at the Dollar Tree, you know, those nice sized ones. Get creative in the vessel in which you place your gift items in. And the sky is the limit. If you know a family or have a friend that's down on their luck, you know, with food or whatever, make them up a food gift basket. Get things that are shelf stable. You could go with a theme, for example, like Italian dinner night, for example. You could get spaghetti and the sauces and some cheeses, all the foods. And, of course, include a cute, you know, sweet little dessert treat in there, like basically from soup to nuts. If you want to try a different theme and just make it, you know, all dessert theme, again, shelf stable, or if you just want to go like a whole junk food thing theme. I did a gift basket of various popcorns, various flavors, and chocolates, and all sorts of fun edibles. You don't have to spend an arm and a leg in those specialty places. If the person that you want to gift enjoys fruit, it's healthier for them in their situation, then you make up your own fruit basket. Get creative. For example, you could also go to the Dollar Tree. You know those like little hams that are in the tins? Have like a ham dinner, like shelf stable those little hams in the tins from that company, that DAC company. They're great. Fill it up with things like pantry items that stay. Those hams, those spams, anything like that that you know that person likes, that if you know them well. You could do a cheese and cracker theme basket. All sorts of, you know, appetizers that are shelf stable. You don't have to spend an arm and a leg in one of those companies that they make up a basket for you. And half the time, the food they send, it's all basket and no food. I mean, and they're expensive too. So, I mean, what's to stop you from, you know, getting creative right under your nose and take advantage of what's on sale at the grocery store? And you just may be helping someone, for example, on a winter day, if you bought them a whole bunch of shelf-stable canned foods that they put away in their pantry, believe you me, they're going to be thinking a lot of happy thoughts at you on that snow day when they can't get out. So to me, those are the gifts that keep on giving. This I did even like with like aunts and cousins and stuff. And one time my aunt told me, and she said, "Boy, I'm so glad you got me that tea that time," because I'd made up like a basket full of like teas and coffees and all sorts of, you know, nice drinks, you know, for the winter with some cookies. I said, "What do you mean?" She said, "I thought I ran out of tea." She thought she ran out of tea. And then, nope, the light bulb went off. She says, "Oh, wait a minute. Janet got me that beautiful box of tea that I put away in the pantry." So get the wheels turning. If you cannot figure out gifts, and especially this year, that people are really like in need of basics, you can make up this, you can make up even a silly basket full of, you know, silly but necessary stuff of things like paper towels, bathroom tissue, shampoo. They're not that silly when you need them and money's tight. You know what I'm saying? Just get creative, make it fun. And sometimes, for example, like if you do like food accessories, but you still want them to have like a fresh piece of meat or something, what's to stop you from throwing a $10 bill in a card and an envelope in that gift basket so they could use that at the grocery store to make that meat purchase, you know, for the fresh food? The sky's the limit. I just thought I'd encourage everyone that these are really creative ideas. The sky's the limit. You could go with party themes, snack themes, just fun themes, or like really pantry items, which I strongly suggest this year that a lot of people could really use, like, or like people that are starting off having like their first little baking ware that just normally never do that. Get them their, you know, flour, their basic stuff, flour, baking powder, baking soda, all the things that, you know, we take for granted, wooden spoons, mixing bowls. Just go out to your grocery store, basically, and have a ball. Buy a bunch in quantities. You can make up gifts for 5-10 people. You could do all this with $100. When I made 10 gift baskets, only $100. And they were generous baskets. So you can incorporate the help of stuff from your Dollar Tree and the best prices that you could get at your local grocery store. So, you know, seriously, like, do not hesitate to do that. Get the shelf-stable items. Consider the specific family that you are making your purchase for. Make their Christmas brighter. And if you do get a whole bunch of practical gifts in there, include one frivolous gift. Include one item. Even throw in a piggy bank for those that are trying to start their little savings tips and tricks, you know, in the year 2021. Get people motivated to start doing the cracks, crevices, nook and cranny types of savings. You know what I'm trying to say? So I encourage everybody to think they don't have to travel far. All they have to do is look underneath their nose at their local grocery store. Set a price, work within, create a theme, get creative, and have a ball. And in the meantime, this has been Jan from New York City. Thank you so much for listening. Why? Because I really do appreciate whose time? Your time. Don't forget to come back tomorrow for some more information. And you have yourselves a wonderful day. No, scratch that. Have a great day.